friends. She got a little bit of drama with her friends. She got a little bit of drama with her friends. She got a little bit of drama with her friends. She got a little bit of drama with her friends. She got a little bit of drama with her friends. Hi guys, this is my new hair. And I absolutely love it. I can't believe it turned out this amazing. I wasn't even expecting it to be this fucking good, like shit. But right now I'm currently out in nature. Life is amazing, beautiful. Hi guys, as you can tell, your girl is a redhead now. So what's happened was, a couple days ago, I felt an impulse that I needed to dye my hair, and I chose red just because it was like I don't really need to bleach it like that, and you know, I knew I'd look good with it, so I was just like, I'm gonna do it. Because you know, sometimes you feel that point in life where you just need like a change, and that was me. Anyways, I'm gonna tell you guys how I got my hair from like black. This is my first time dyeing my hair, and I can't believe I did this at home. But how to dye it from black to this like magenta red. And I went through some mistakes, so I'm gonna bring you guys to the process so you guys don't make the same fucking mistakes, because it was kind of stressful, which is why I didn't really get that many videos in of me dyeing my hair, because it was just too stressful to be filming at the same time when I'm not no professional YouTuber or nothing like that. But yeah, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I got my blackity black hair to this nice magenta red hair. And I'm gonna show you guys all the mistakes that happened between, because this took two processes. So first things first is, you want to go to your local Sally's and get the L'Oreal High Color in magenta, and also a 30 volume developer. For my hair, I use 30 volume developer, but the higher the developer you go, like 40-50, then the faster it will process and the lighter your hair can get, so the brighter it can get. But for me, I just use 30 because I never dyed my hair before. For my hair, at first I got two tubes of the L'Oreal High Color, but we ran out of the color. So honestly, if you guys have like medium to long hair, I honestly recommend you getting like 3 to 4 tubes to start, and just return them if you guys don't use it. But so I bought 2 tubes and we ran out of coloring, so my hair at first did not turn magenta. Okay, it did not turn magenta, did not turn red. So I had to go back, buy more coloring, and redo it. But another mistake that we made is, at first I was doing my hair at my homegirl's house and she didn't have no measuring cups for me, so we just eyeballed the developer. But you want to use 1/3 cup of developer for every tube you use. So if you use 2 tube of color, you want to use 2/3 cup of developer. And the first time I did my hair compared to the second time, the mixture is way thicker the first time, so I already knew that we messed that part up. And I feel like why we ran out of dye, so maybe 2 tubes would work. But to be safe, I say buy like 3 or 4 and just start with 2 and then return the rest if you don't need the extras. So what I did was, we first did a test strand on my hair just to see how my hair would react and how it would process. And it turned out great, and we proceeded with the rest of the head. But halfway there, we ran out of dye, so my hair like stayed freaking black for like the top half of the section. But what I did was I started dyeing my hair from the bottom up and left that on for 20 minutes, and then the last 20 minutes I hit the roots. So that gave me a very even coloring and like nothing lighter on the roots and more processed than compared to the ends. I washed my hair 2 times already and the water in my shower is still so freaking red. So is it gonna be red every time I wash it? Like, while I was at Sally's, the lady had shown me this like whole new section that I'd never seen before, which is like the generic version of shampoo and conditioners. Like the one that she recommended for me is the It's a 10 shampoo and conditioner, and the conditioner is amazing. You want to use sulfate free shampoos because sulfates are the bigger molecules that like open your cuticles up, and that's what lets the color out, if that makes sense. But yeah, as you guys can tell, my hair came out freaking beautiful. So if you guys want to dye your hair and is hesitating, I honestly say fuck it, just do it. And I think you're gonna be really happy with the outcome, because I was like real I was just unsure of what the outcome would be like, but I am more than happy with how my hair turned out, and thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for watching my video. Until next time.